So lecture 9 quiz review is on glucose metabolism. This one's a little easier to follow because of the process of glucose metabolism, but there are a few questions here or there that can kind of trip some people up. For example, this first one, I talk about balancing the chemistry, balancing the chemical equation. Well, that's all photosynthesis and aerobic metabolism are two sides of the same coin. Their energy transfer, their biochemistry, organic chemistry. And in chemistry, when we say balance the equation, we're basically saying that we cancel out things on both sides of the equations. So for example, photosynthesis uses carbon dioxide and water, and aerobic metabolism produces carbon dioxide and water. So those cancel out. Photosynthesis produces glucose and oxygen. Aerobic metabolism uses glucose and oxygen. So those cancel out. So what are you left with? You're left with the fact that light essentially ends up as an ATP energy source. This goes through a lot of different steps and a lot of different molecules, but the end result is that all of the ATP that drives our muscles, our neurons, all of the movement in our cells, everything that's controlled by this transfer of energy came from the sun. That's the long or the short of this concept here, is that we are light-driven animals, just we do not harness the light directly. That's why plants have to do that for us. And this is, again, getting into ecosystems and the importance of maintaining food that we can be sustainable, because you and I can't produce our own food. We have to eat something that's already produced it. So that's what I mean by balancing the equation. When I say, where does all the energy in your body ultimately come from? It comes from the sun. It comes from the light that emanates from the sun. So that one's a little difficult unless it's explained like that. The others are fairly straightforward and simple. It fundamentally comes down to the four steps of aerobic metabolism or aerobic respiration. But there is a question that I'll ask about these three types of respiration. Make sure you understand that aerobic is the most efficient because it uses oxygen. Anaerobic is the exact same process as aerobic, but it uses something other than oxygen, so it's a little less efficient. And fermentation, as you know, is separate from mitochondria. You don't get much energy out of that one at all. You only get the energy from glycolysis, so this is the least efficient. So from left to right, those are the most to least efficient. Now, most of your questions can be summed up by this picture right here. Basically, I'm going to ask you question after question about these four steps: glycolysis, preparatory reactions, Krebs cycle, electron transport chain. That's most of the answers in your quiz. And the questions will range from which step makes no ATP, preparatory reactions, to where oxygen's used. And I do some other things like blood doping. I talk about oxygen being increased. It's just basically asking where oxygen's used, and that's the electron transport chain. Where most of your food is broken down into carbon dioxide, where most of the electron carriers are made. Again, this is a really good picture to have for this quiz. And it'll just walk you through everything. The only questions that are a little different are the fermentation questions at the end. So make sure you know these two concepts. Number one, fermentation's only job is to recycle the electron carriers. Let me say that again. Fermentation's only job is to recycle the electron carriers. Remember, that job is normally done in the mitochondria, but if you don't have mitochondria, like in the case of these microbes that undergo fermentation all the time, or in humans, when we reach our limit to aerobic respiration and we have to kick in some fermentation on the side with glycolysis, that's because we need to recycle the electron carriers. This is the concept that people usually have the hardest time with fermentation. So no matter what the case is, whether you're alcohol production or lactic acid production, which is you and I, it's to recycle these electron carriers so that glycolysis can continue to make ATP. Okay? So there are two questions. One generally focuses on just bacteria and microbes undergoing fermentation. The other one focuses on why humans have to undergo fermentation during exercise. Okay, so those are the two types of questions you'll have on fermentation. All the others will basically be on these four steps. And so pay close attention to where they take place, if I say which step only can take place in any organism, that's glycolysis, right? Because it doesn't matter whether you have mitochondria or not, all cells, whether bacteria, human, plant, animal, whatever, can undergo glycolysis. So if I say which process can all cells undergo, that's glycolysis. And that's why this picture is nice too, because it shows you taking place outside of the cytoplasm. Okay. Also, electron transport chain, remember, takes place on the cristae, where the Krebs cycle is in the matrix. Sometimes I talk about the matrix and the cristae. You got to know those terms for some of the questions as well.